Zener diode. It is a properly doped crystal diode and has sharp breakdown voltage. And you can see that when current passes through Zener diode, and if the external voltage is greater than VZ, then the Zener diode acts as a cell. Or else, when external voltage is less than Zener voltage, it becomes like zero current passes through the Zener diode. So, solving for different cases, let's say that when EI is fixed and RL is fixed, we can see and find whether it passed the Zener diode acts or not. So, for that, we have to take that as an open circuit and then calculate the voltage that can be allowed upon the Zener voltage. EI by R plus RL. EI by R plus RL into RL. That is the voltage that can be applied across the Zener diode part. So if that part, that E naught is greater than VZ, then there is a passage of current in this Zener diode. So when we keep fixed EI and variable RL, you can see that RL changes and EI is single. EI is fixed. Then you have to take like Zener volt, Zener in on stage load voltage is E naught. So when RL is minimum, IL is maximum as E naught is fixed. So when we check like IL is maximum, E naught by RL minimum is equal to VZ by RL minimum. So you can see that whenever there is a high voltage resistance value, there is a less load current, and when high load resistance is there, low load resistance is there, high load current is there, and I is fixed, it does not changes. IZ and IL changes for each stage. And similarly, when RL for RL maximum and RL minimum is given here, and when fixed RL, the load resistance in the fixed and variable internal input voltage, you can see that EI minimum is equal to RI R plus RL into VZ by RL, as VZ is equal to E naught at any point of time. You can see that EI RL, this formula is transformed into this. VZ is equal to RL, EI by R plus RL is changed to EI minimum is equal to R plus RL into VZ by RL.